I gotta go. I'll be right back. You understand? And then all of those who were associates of each other, they would run together, right? So they would all come into their own groups and they would begin to discuss about Krishna's lila. You understand? So they didn't even openly speak even amongst young girls. What to speak anywhere else? But when Akrura came, pulling the chariot away at that time, openly, they professed their love and their great separation and their great feeling that Krishna's leaving. And it says, Rudasma means they were crying, openly showing their affection. And Suswaram means in such a sweet voice, they began singing, Govinda Damo Dharamadaveti, Govinda Damo Dharamadaveti. So think about it. Srila Gurudev was so expert in his training to us. He would wait until, I don't know where that started. When Gurudev came in 96, I was there that first tour, right? I can't remember if we were doing it then or not. But whenever Gurudev would leave, what would everybody do? Govinda Damo Dharamadaveti. So he taught this. So now Radhika has her chance in the garden at Yameswara Tota in Jagannath Puri to speak every day to Mahaprabhu openly. Openly, even though using Vyanjan Vritti and Parokshvad. Vyanjan Vritti means indirect meanings. Parokshvad means the same thing. Because Krishna says, Paroksham Mamasa Cha Priyam. I like it if somebody talks poetically, indirectly. So speaking all the sweet verses of Bhagavatam, my voice is like a horse's voice. Could you imagine the voice of Vidara Pandit? How he's speaking the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, all according to the different emotional meters that accompany them? Because it's Radharani speaking. And he's telling to Mahaprabhu there. Then he tells Mahaprabhu, and here's your homework. Mahaprabhu goes back to the Gambira, and in the Gambira he still needs a tutor. Ramananda Roy and Swarup Damodar, Lalita Vishaka, they're there, you need tutoring. But you cannot cheat. So we won't tell you the answers. But what we'll do is we'll inspire you to think of it. Right? So then they'll sing. Any beautiful song of Vijayapati, Jayadeva Goswami, Chandidas. And then Mahaprabhu, now I understand something. So this was the pattern. But an amazing thing, which brings us to tonight, was that what charit did Gadadhar Pandit speak so many times to Mahaprabhu? Narasingha Prahala Charit. You understand? So now think about it. This is Radharani speaking to Mahaprabhu to instruct him how to taste the moods of Radhika, and what he spoke mostly was Narasingha Prahala Charit.
Charit?
Charit means glories. How powerful is this Narasingha Prahala Charit? So many lessons are embedded here, but also the highest type of prema is embedded here. But only if you go very deeply you can see where that prema is. The Vaikuntha planets are so beautiful you cannot imagine. Vaikuntha, does it exist in Golok Vrindavan or not? In our Gokul Braj, is Vaikuntha there? Or not?
Yes.
Is Braj is not in Vaikuntha? Certainly. Braj is in Vaikuntha. In the topmost section of Vaikuntha, you find Braj. So everything of Vaikuntha is there in Braj. Vaikuntha is Janato Vadu Madhupuri, right? Rupa Goswami saying, Vaikuntha, Madhupuri, every other dham related to those two, they're all there in Braj, and Braj's sweetness completely covers them, so Braj is prominent. Therefore, higher than Vaikuntha, Mathura, Ayodhya, everything else, Dwarka, Mathura, is this Braj. Understand? He also said in Gopi Ghi, Jayati De Adikam Janmana Braja. What is it? Chalada Indira Shashrat Atrahi. Since you've come to this Braj, even Lakshmi Devi, the goddess of fortune, she's residing here. Because what does goddess of fortune residing there mean? Goddess of fortune means the Shakti of goddess of fortune is residing in Braj. So that means all power, which makes Vaikuntha glorious, is also residing in Braj. Undercover. Vaikuntha is so beautiful. Even our great saints and rishis, in connection with great kings, right? They, Jedi. In connection with great kings, they built duplicates of that Vaikuntha. So if you go to South India, has anybody been to South India? You go to South Indian temples? What do they call their temples? Bhu Loka Vaikuntha. So if you go to Sri Rangam, you go to Padmanabha Swami, you go anywhere, Bhu Loka Vaikuntha means Vaikuntha here on Bhu Loka. Right? And so those kings, from the advice given and the insight given by Rishi, they built it according to the description of Vaikuntha. So Vaikuntha is so beautiful. There are seven different gates on all the sides of Vaikuntha. On each of the gates, there are eight different directions, but there are four prominent pairs of dwarapalaks or gate guards. Dattaviratta, Bhadra Subhadra, Bala Subhala. And on the western gate, the most favorite dwarapalaks of Sri Narayan are Jai and Vijay. In that Vaikuntha Dham, Jai and Vijay are doing all kinds of services. We are accustomed to seeing that they only guard the door of Vaikuntha. But they are Vaikuntha Vasis. They serve the Lord in so many different ways. One way that they serve the Lord also is to guard the Lord's inner chamber. If you go into any temple in South India, they have the time which is called Shayan. Shayan means sleeping, resting time. At that time when they put the Lord to rest, right, and they close the gates, who's on the front two doors of those inner chamber doors? The inner chamber has two doors besides the big doors outside. Who's on those inner chamber doors? Standing there, you know, with the cluttering. So they're not only the outside gates of Vaikuntha, they also guard the inner chamber of Sri Narayan. So, once while they were guarding that inner chamber of Sri Narayan, Sri Lakshmiji, after massaging the lotus feet of Sri Narayan, she went out in order to obtain some things to render service. When she left, she was gone for some time. So the Lord told to Jai and Vijay, listen, when Sri Lakshmiji comes back, I know to you she's like mother. But I'm going to rest now, and I don't want to be disturbed at all. Don't even let Lakshmi Devi come in. So what kind of trick the Lord is playing? If anybody did that here now, we'd all have to find somewhere to sleep. If I told my daughter, hey, when your mom comes home, don't open the door, because I'm resting. See how that would work out. So anyways, so when Lakshmi Devi came back to that door, Jai and Vijay, there was some bewildered. What will do? We have really no jurisdiction over Lakshmi Devi. In a moment, she can do anything she likes. But at the same time, Sri Narayan is her pati, and she's subservient to Sri Narayan. So the order of Narayan is superior even to the presence of Lakshmi Devi. Is it like that in Vrindavan?
No.
No. Okay. So, but in Vaikuntha, that's how it works. So, you know, so here now some people say, oh, maybe I want Vaikuntha, maybe I don't want Vaikuntha. You understand? But no, so they told, Mahalakshmi, our Prabhu has mentioned that while resting he does not want to be disturbed by anyone. So please, very humbly accept our order from Prabhu that nobody can enter the inner chamber at this time. So Lakshmi Devi, she was some bewildered, but she looked at them with a, do you know who I am? Look. Understand? Perhaps the order is for all others, including you and your brother. But, do you understand who I am? So, not budging, not moving one inch, Lakshmi Devi in her mind, she began to contemplate. Is this some kind of trick? Have these two also been influenced by something? Maybe their power has gone to their head. Because they're so well treated by my Prabhu, they began to think they have control and monopoly over everything, including me. Perhaps they're acting outside the order of our Prabhu. Huh. They perhaps need to learn a lesson. And just as Lakshmi Devi thought, I should give them a curse to teach them a lesson, in her mind one apprehension came. But if they are telling the truth, and I curse them, then, what will be my fate and how will my Prabhu Sri Narayan respond to this? Because I know how dear these two are to him. So mentally, Lakshmi Devi, she thought of the curse, but she did not utter from her mouth. At the same time, four mind-born sons of Brahma, who were completely liberated souls, they themselves personify all the qualities necessary for liberation, tapasya, yoga, jnana, and vairagya. These four qualities, if one gains jnana, then he can obtain vairagya. Vairagya means detachment from material sense enjoyment. If you will obtain detachment from material sense enjoyment, you can do saranagati, which is tapasya. Real meaning of tapasya, saranagati. But unless you have some spirit of renunciation, you can't truly do it. That's why Srila Gaura Govinda Maharaj used to say, what about everybody? Surrender.
Conditional,
partial, or artificial. Surrender. He was saying everybody's surrender is partial, artificial, or conditional. So unless you truly have vairagya, which is based on realized jnana, you can't truly do tapasya or saranagati. If you can do these three things, then you can obtain yoga. Yoga means liberation. So the four kumaras are the embodiment of these four qualities. But without bhakti, can these four qualities give you the lotus feet of Bhagavan?
No.
Therefore, even though Brahma created these four mind-born sons, still he was unsatisfied. So in his continued process of creation, what happened next? So rather than from his mind, what was the next manifestation in his creation? It came from where?
From the heart.
And who was born from Brahma's heart?
Narada Muni Vajayana Radhikaram.
So Narada Muni appears with a veena, and he's so inspiring, the veena singing on its own. Right? We used to have imitation at Jimi Hendrix. He had a guitar, he used to try to make the guitar talk by itself. Right? He would be doing different things and hope to get the. Right? Not the same. Narada Muni inspired his own veena. That it was personified with bhakti. So the veena sang. So they're doing kirtan back and forth. Narada Muni's chanting, Navina's chanting. Like this. So this is the bhakti that was born from the heart of Sri Brahmaji. So these four qualities are insufficient to give bhakti. They are helpful for bhakti, but they're insufficient in and of themselves to give bhakti. So unless they are endowed with bhakti shakti themselves, they cannot reveal the goal of bhakti. Then, so these four mind-born sons of Brahma, they became very curious. We have heard from our older brother, and also from Lord Shiva, and also from others, about the beauty and glory of Sri Narayan. But you, our father, Sri Brahmaji, you, our father, you've never told us about this. It is the duty of every father to be the adiguru of his children. So be kind to us, even though we did not fulfill your desire. Because what was Brahma's desire? That they should populate the world. But if you have any kind of jnana, any kind of understanding, what was your answer be? Strictly red cloth brahmachari. Right? Not doing it. So they were like that. So even though we could not fulfill your desire, Pitaji, please, you should be merciful to us and still tell us about the glories of Sri Narayan. So Brahma, of course, he was very moved. And he began to speak about the glories of Sri Narayan. He started his kirtan, Lakshmi Narayana, 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 Lakshmi Narayana, Narayana. Becoming completely absorbed, he began describing all the Harikatha and the beauty of Sri Vaikuntha. He told of the seven gates. He told them about the beauty of all the inhabitants of Vaikuntha having four arms in darkish, bluish, and golden hues. He told them about the beauty of the ornaments and opulence of Vaikuntha. He told them that Sri Narayan is the Lavanya Saram of Vaikuntha. Lavanya Saram means the essence of all the beauty of Vaikuntha. Therefore, everyone has a roop which is like Lord Narayan's. You understand? This is why they're beautiful. It is mentioned, it's called Swa Rupya Mukti, Swa Lokya Mukti, Sa Lokya Sa Rupya Mukti, etc. Understand? So he was describing all these things. He began to describe the kindness of Lord Narayan. He told so many beautiful pastimes of Lakshmi Narayan. When the four Kumaras heard all of this, their Brahmavad, which was attained by dint of their personification of the four qualities I mentioned, they became very eager to find and to have darshan of Shri Narayan. Immediately at that time, they left and they began wandering here and there to find Lord Narayan. The only thing they had was the kirtan given to them by their father. Ah, Lakshmi Narayana Narayana Narayan, Lakshmi Narayana Narayana Narayana. Now, this kirtan itself, because it's non-different from Narayan, it guided them by heart, being pure souls, to the first gate. Easily they passed through. Second gate, easily they passed through. Third gate, easily. Fourth gate, easily. Fifth gate, easily. Sixth gate, easily. Turned around, looked at it, and you know, you understand? They came to the seventh gate of Vaikuntha. At that seventh gate, on the inner part of that seventh gate, they saw two personalities. These two personalities were so beautiful, and they fit every description they had heard from Lord Brahma. But they said, they cannot be two Narayans. So this was the clue, they cannot be Narayan, because two of them, and they equally cannot be Narayan. But who are these beautiful persons? So they immediately approached these two persons. And as they approached these two persons, the four Kumaras, unfortunately, because of their complete absorption, right, in renunciation, they never bothered to grow up, and they never bothered to get dressed either. You understand? So when they arrived at Vaikuntha, everyone in Vaikuntha is very opulently dressed, very beautiful, everything. But at least not in your Brahmin underwear. This is the point. Right? At least not in a kopin. Right? We can deal, if you come as a sadhu, not a muni, he doesn't dress fancy. He comes here all the time. But you guys showed up in a Brahmin thread and a kopin. Is that? So this is the first thing, Jayan Vijayan, who are these people? You understand? They've also never seen anyone like this. But they are so effulgent. They appear to be very, very powerful. But then Vijay told to Jai, hey, simply being powerful, being effulgent, even being liberated, is it the quality by which you can enter Vaikuntha? No. So he told, they've passed through six gates already. This discussion, Jai and Vijay, they've passed through six gates already. Kam, Krodh, Loha, Moha, Mada, Matsalya. All of the things that plague everyone in this world. Somebody say in English what they are? Lust, anger, greed. What else?
Envy.
Envy, illusion, madness. You understand? So they easily pass through these gates, right? Easily. Through six gates, brush, no problem. Because of who they are. But the seventh gate required something else. What did it require? Bhakti. You cannot enter Vaikuntha simply on the basis of everything else. You can obtain Brahman. You can attain Paramatma Darshan. You understand? You can attain Atma Tattva Darshan. Means you can see your own self. And all the qualities of Atma. But you cannot obtain Darshan of Bhagavan by this. You understand? Nayam Atma Pravachanena Labdhya Na Merasa Na Hushutena Eva Isha Vinute Tena Labdhyas Tasha Eva Isha Vi Vinute Tanu Swam. It means that Bhagavan can reveal himself to whom he wants to. Right? Also, what's the verse in Bhagavad Gita? Yoga Maya Samamrita. Naham Prakasha Savasha Yoga Maya Samamrita. So even if you reach to the position where Bhagavan is, he reserves the right. Yoga Maya Samamrita. He reserves the right to be covered by his yoga maya. So even those who are liberated in Brahman, Paramatma, other things, he can still cover himself from their vision. But what did the four Kumaras have that is the unique quality of obtaining mercy?
Greed.
They had greed because they heard Harikatha from Brahma. You understand? But the four Kumaras, in their greed, don't mistake this, Sastra says they became angry. If they became angry, how could they be calm, crow, bro? How could they have conquered those if they became angry? So what happened? The transcendental greed that they had manifested a mood that was like anger. You understand? Not anger. Because of his money and anger, how could they have obtained the gate of Vaikuntha? So their greed to see Lord Narayan. It manifested a mood of its own. An eagerness to do something, like an eagerness to see a loved one. People may do very crazy things. I remember there was a story some years ago, one lady, she fell in love with somebody on the East Coast. She drove from Texas in her car, right, without using the bathroom, making any stops, straight driving with gas cans, everything, so we didn't have to stop, right? The astronaut lady, right? Intelligent, been to the moon or something, but couldn't figure out what is love in the material world. Okay, so this kind of determination when greed arises in the heart can do amazing things, right? We know the story of Bilbo Mungo Thakur, right? So when greed comes from lust, we also do amazing things, right? When greed comes from spiritual life, we do amazing things. What was Mahaprabhu's crazy thing he did in greed to obtain Krishna? Took sannyas. He told his mother, "Oh, mother, I went crazy." When he came back, somebody said, "Oh, mother, I went crazy. Your love for me, your affection for me is so great. But in that moment of madness and greed, I left home, left all my friends. I left your love and affection. I left the love and affection of my devoted wife. And I didn't catch a limousine ride to Katwa. I jumped in the Ganges with crocodiles, everything swam over there. And then even when Kesha Bharti told me, "Hey, look, I don't know if I could do this. You need to first go back and get permission." "Okay, hold on, I'll be right back." He ran to jump in the Ganges again. "Oh, okay, hold on. I understand your greed now." It's mentioned in Bhakti Ratnakara. So they had greed, and their greed manifested a mood that was like anger. And in that anger, they said, "Hey, we heard all about Vaikuntha already from Brahmaji, and Brahmaji cannot tell a lie. Therefore, we know in this Vaikuntha, everyone is completely like Bhagavan. They completely have samadarshan." Samadarshan means like equal vision. They can see clearly what's what. "So therefore, we know also that in many of Bhagavan's Leela, some demons and imposters have come, finding you outside the gate of Vaikuntha. Maybe you're not truly Vaikunthavasis. Maybe you're imitators and imposters. And you should know we have the power to curse such imitators and imposters. Oh, you don't believe me? I can show you better than I can tell you." That time, four Kumaras, after speaking to Jaya Vijaya in this manner, they told, "Listen, because of your attitude and your mood, you cannot possibly be residents of Vaikuntha. Therefore, we experienced this thing before. We saw it in the material world around the way. We saw how people would act like this. Therefore, we are going to give you the opportunity to join your cohorts in the material world. So we're giving you a curse." Right? Immediately when the four Kumaras pronounced this curse, because in those days, you could assess the power of someone in their vach, means they're speaking. You understand? Right? It's always said that you can tell a fool when he... Similarly, you can tell the power of someone when they speak. You can't always assess by your eyes. Right? Like Ashtalakra, Rishi, when he came into the assembly of sages or scholars. Right? They looked at him and thought, right? But when he began to speak, then they could understand, oh, what kind of high class of Sadhu Rishi he is. In the same way, once they began to speak, then Jaya Vijaya could understand, oh, what have we done? Immediately at that time, Bhagavan, Jiva Goswami mentioned, Krishna Sundava and Bhagavat Sundava, he mentioned, that time, Sri Narayan, because his heart is taratmic with his devotees, he could understand what had transpired. He told Lakshmi, let's go. Getting on the back of Garuda, they took Garuda and they rode to the front gate, the western gate of Vaikuntha. At that time, when they arrived close to the gate, they disembarked. At that time, Garuda, when he was approaching the gate, he was flapping his wings. The sounds of Garuda's wings does what? The Vedas come. So the four Kumaras, they can hear from a distance. They could hear the sounds of Vedic hymns coming. What is that? They became stunned. The beauty of the sounds in Vaikuntha. Then as Bhagavan got closer, his garland that he wears, right? The fragrance of that garland permeated the entire area outside the gate of Vaikuntha. For Kumaras, they smell that. You understand? Then Lord Narayan said, okay, I'm ready for the... I can never say this. The Pierre is a stone? Is that what it is? Okay, I got it. My wife always said, it's not Pierre. Not Pierre. Okay? So, then they got down off the back of Garuda and coming to the front gate on foot in Vaikuntha. That time, a breeze blew. Vaikuntha, a breeze blew. And it swept up from the lotus feet of Lord Narayan what? What aroma? What stays on the lotus feet of Lord Narayan? Tulasi. So it swept up the fragrance of Tulasi and carried that breeze ahead of Narayan. And that breeze entered the nostril of the four Kumaras. That time, all Asta Satvik Vikar came in their bodies. When Lord Narayan came to the gate, they could faintly see because now Asru, tears had come to their eyes, shivering, everything. They could not express anything. They were crying. They were trying to see. Is this that very Narayan that Brahma talked about? They could not tell because they were overcome by ecstatic symptoms. Then to add on top the cherry, on top of everything, the Lord opened his mouth and spoke. O Brahmins. He didn't sound like that. I'm just doing my Denzel so I could try. O Brahmins. Listen. Because my own associates have offended you, and because the Brahmins are like my own body, I take it that I have personally offended you. Then the Lord began to go on. He began to speak so many wonderful things about the Brahmins. He began to speak how he eats through the mouth of the Brahmins. Because in a fire sacrifice, it's not only through the Devatas and Agni, but what do you do at a fire sacrifice afterwards? You have to feed the Brahmins. I eat through the mouth of the Brahmins. So the Lord spoke like that. Jai and Vijay were there in a very repentant mood, also drinking the nectar of the Lord's words. What did Jai and Vijay understand from those words? The Lord was glorifying. Oh, you Brahmins, you are as dear to me as my own self. Jai and Vijay were thinking, we are yourselves. Our hearts have always been tied with you. Right? So they were hearing that Bhagavan was talking to them and saying, oh, okay, don't worry about it. You've made this mistake. Do you know what Swami's saying this? Krama Sandarbha. Right? You've made this mistake. But actually, you are so near and dear to me, no curse can touch you. You understand? This is what he's saying to Jai. So, Jai and Vijay are hearing, and four Kumaras are hearing something different. Okay, Abhishek is getting ready. I'm going to have to try to speak up. So now, the four Kumaras in Srimad Bhagavatam is directly mentioned. They could no longer understand what the Lord was saying. They were in such an ecstatic mood, they could not understand. So the Lord said, listen, you should know that the curse which was placed on them, it was ordained by me. Formerly, my own Lakshmi Devi also wanted to curse them. So now it comes out in the open. At that time, Lakshmi Devi, being not permitted to enter my inner chamber by my own request, she thought to curse them also. Because of this curse of Lakshmi Devi, and because now the curse of the four Kumaras, with my blessing, with my sanction, right? I'm allowing this. It's mentioned in the Krama Sandarbha. Jaya Vijaya Shonak Adi Sat Vyajema Swabhakta Vinodaya Virarase. Jaya Vijaya Shonak Adi. Jaya Vijaya, when they were cursed by Shonak Adi, means the four Kumaras, Sat Vyajema, on the pretense of a curse. Swabhakta Vinodaya. I was able to enjoy with my own bhaktas Virarase. So Jiva Goswami is directly clarifying how the Lord ordained that curse. Then he told, Sam Rama Sam Britya Samadhi Anubhadi Yoga. You will go down to the planet Earth for three births. He gave them the option, three births by the curse of the Kumaras or seven births by the curse of Lakshmi. Which one do you want? What did they pick? Why did they pick three births instead of seven?
Jiva
Goswami specifically mentioned not. Mm-hmm. Srila Prabhupada wrote to encourage us that we should think, I'm not in a lila. So as soon as I can get back, if you can arrange it, please put it on your schedule, whatever the next appointment is. Right? We can't say, well, if you want me to be able to continue my book distribution for another couple of years. No. As soon as you get an opening, I'm ready.
Also, the Lord also desires to enjoy Hiraras, and nobody is sufficient to, like, satisfy the Lord.
Exactly. So the Lord gave them, you can take seven births as devotees. Would the Lord experience Hiraras No. So to fulfill the desire of the Lord, it means they knew the Manubhishta of Narayan. This is called anyabilasika sunya. This is pure devotion. So he told him, Samrama Sambritya, your bhakti yoga will be intensified by anger. So Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakasipu, their bhakti was based, its intensity, on anger. The more angry they became, the more devotion they were showing. This is a deep thing. It's a very deep thing. You understand? So now, he told him, so go and you will take three births. Right? So first birth is at Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakasipu. Second birth, Ravan and Kumbhakarna. Third birth, and Dantavakra. So now taking birth is Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakasipu. They also, so much meaning is here. Hiranyaksha means, Aksha means eyes. So whose eyes are filled with gold? Why gold? Gold means the Kanti, the Vastu Varna of Lakshmi Devi, Shrimati Radhika also. This gold Vastu Varna is filled with power. It is filled with power to enjoy for the pleasure of Bhagavan. You understand what I'm saying? The Vastu Varna of Lakshmi Devi Radhika is gold. Everything is meant to serve Narayan and give pleasure to Lord Narayan. When you put that Vastu Varna in your own eyes and digest it for your enjoyment, this is called Hiranyaksha. You understand? Because what goes in your eyes goes to where? Right? If you never see that woman, would you have attraction for her? You never wrote a love letter to the lady you didn't see. And vice versa. So through the eyes you drink into the heart. You understand? So Hiranyaksha means to drink the power of enjoyment that's due to Bhagavan. For me, this is called Hiranyaksha. Therefore, Jiva Goswami wrote, Puranas. But why did he say this is called Aridaitya? Because this is the Aridaitya in the heart of all jivas. You understand? The desire to enjoy separate from Bhagavan, but with Bhagavan's power. Because can you find another power to enjoy? Maya is what? She's the shadow shakti of Mula Shakti Tattva. You can't make your own power to enjoy it. You have to enjoy by the power given from the shakti. That shadow of Mool Shakti Tattva is Maya Devi. Other than that, you don't have your own power to enjoy it. If Krishna turns off the sunlight tomorrow, what will your enjoyment be? Panic. If you wake up tomorrow and it's dark, first thing you say, am I okay? Am I alright? Yeah, I remember one time, I thought I couldn't breathe, right? I mean, Mohini, Mohini. So she said, look, you're talking to me, calm down. Because if you're talking, you're breathing, right? So calm down. Right? So everyone, their enjoyment is based on Bhagavan providing the power for you to enjoy. You understand? So this is Hiranyaksha. Right? So that tendency to enjoy separate from Bhagavan is killed by service to Bhagavan. Service to Bhagavan is called yajna. Therefore, yajna personified appeared to kill Hiranyaksha. Who is yajna personified? Varaha Devi. The body of Varaha is constituted of all of the Vedas. His hair is the Kusha grass. His tusks are the shuk and shuv of yajna. Because by yajna, what is the Bhagavad Gita verse? Jagnahat kamano yanyatra lokayam karma bandana. Any jiva is bound in this world if he doesn't perform yajna. Therefore, we're doing Nam Sankirtan, but what do we call it? Sankirtan Yajna. Yes. So without yajna, every jiva is bound in this world. So to get rid of this adidaitya tendency in the jiva, yajna is necessary. And joy still remains. That subtle tendency is manifest as one's own desire for Adi Ras. Therefore, the brother of Hiranyaksha is named Hiranya. Same thing, Hiranya means gold, the power of enjoyment. Kasipu. What is Kasipu in this case? It means? It means soft bed. What happens on soft beds? Or hard beds, or cars, or anything else in the material world. Okay? So you get the idea. So, that Adi Rasa is the mundane feature of sex life in the material world. Actually, mundane sex life in the material world is the idea of playing God. I want the essence of the essential power of enjoyment. Do you understand what sex life is in the material world? It's the perverted reflection of the essential Ross between Radha and Krishna. This is why sannyas is what sannyas is. Jiva Goswami says, until Sura Antakaran's jet, until your Antakara means your inner body, your mind, false ego is purified from that desire, you can never get actual praying. It won't come in the heart. You understand? So, all of our tribes said, okay, then set up a program to get there. You can't get there all at once. Set up a program to get there. But get there when you can, as the famous song goes. That was the thing. Let me be Bhagavan. Brahma said, well, I can't give you what I don't have. Right? But what we could do is we could work something out in the contract, because your austerities were amazing. I'm not going to deny that. Right? But here you stood around for thousands of years, ants ate you, all kind of things got on you, they actually built an anthill over you, wood came, you couldn't get any water, so all your flesh and bones were eaten and everything, and still, you weren't worried about prasad. You weren't worried that you'd have your potato chips on your codicil or anything. All you wanted to do was obtain your goal. Therefore, you kept your desires in your life running in your bones. Brahma said, that's an amazing thing, I'm not going to deny. Therefore, I'm willing to give you a benediction, but I can't make you immortal because I'm not immortal. Okay, look here, let's work this out. I don't want to be killed in the daytime or at night. I don't want to kill by any human beings. I don't want to kill by any other kind of beings, not even the ones you make, right? I don't want to be killed inside or outside, not in the land or in the sea, not by any creature not made by you, just in case somebody else is making creatures also, not any other creatures also. So he was trying to cover all the spectrum. He did an amazing job, pretty much. Right? So he got all the benedictions in, and Brahma said, okay, so be it. So then when he went back, he said, oh, I got it now. Now I'm Bhagavan. Because that's what happens, right? He said, I'm Bhagavan. So now when he went back to his Bhagavan, right, he said, listen, Hiranyaksha was killed by Vishnu. He's definitely my mortal enemy. But look, I just inherited all this power, Bhagavan thing and all that. So let's just enjoy for a while, right? Especially Bhagavan. So what I want you to do, I've already sent out all my henchmen. Y'all went to Earth and y'all destroying everything, doing everything I want to. Even bringing me things. Minika and all the other upsides and heavenly planets, they're making sweets and they bring them to me first. Right? So everything is fine. Right now, let everything be chill. Right? But what happened? Some Rama, some Britya, Anubhadi, Samadhi, Yoga. Samadhi, Anubhada, Yoga. The Lord told, your bhakti yoga will be intensified by anger. So for Hiranyakasipu not to be angry is not the bhakti that he's supposed to have. So therefore, who is there? He has sons. Among those sons, the best is named? What is Prahlad? Halad means like Haladini or Ananda. Prakrishtrupe and Ananda. That person who is the personification of complete bliss. Who is Prahlad? He also had one Sadaguru. Narada Muni, Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur mentions. Narada Muni and Prahlad, they manifest one Sadaguru to show how one becomes perfect. Other than that, we'll read Bhagavatam and say, wait a minute, Prahlad was always like this? And so they show. So, Prabhuji, what should we do? Because if you need to do a stop, we'll just...
It's neither day nor night right now.
Okay. Time. So we have to continue this another time because it's time for Lord Nrisimhadev to appear, so we'll have to continue it another time.
Fast forward.
So now, Prahlad Maharaj is his son, who's a personification of bliss. It's described that Krishna was his Ishtadev, and Krishna used to personally come and console him when he would feel separation. He used to manifest all the astasattvic bhavs. And when he would be in a deep mood of separation, Krishna would personally come and give darshan. Not give him darshan, Krishna would take him and hold him. Understand? Could you imagine? Right? So now, Prahlad Maharaj was sent off to school. He sat in school. He didn't immediately say, oh, this is all bogus. Antranishtakara bhayalokya vyavyahar. Inside, he was always absorbed. And externally, he learned politics, science. He used to read Time magazine, all that stuff, right? Then, one day, the teachers, Sanda and Amarka, Saunda, complete darkness. Amarka, no light. Right? Those two teachers, they took Prahlad, right? And they took him before his father Hiranyakasipu, very proud. Ah, look at our byproduct here, your son is a genius. Because obviously there's going to be some dakshin rolling here for all of this, right? So Hiranyakasipu was very happy, he picked up Prahlad Maharaj. He put Prahlad Maharaj on his lap. Tell me, son. I don't want to hear the ABCs because this is a high class, very expensive private school. Tell me, what is the best thing you've learned? Tat sarumange asurya varadenam sarasamud vigna sakrahat. Hidatmapatam andakupam. Vanam tano tarim asareta. What I learned, father, oh best of the asuras, is not an insult because Hiranyakasipu, this is his clan, the asuras, so it wasn't insulting. Oh best. Stuck in Griha Medi life, they're always going to be suffering. Sarasamu did not, they're always going to have some problem. Hidatmopatam, they can never understand what is the soul. Andakupam, they remain deeply entrenched in that dark well. What is my suggestion? You should go to the forest. Why? Now listen to this. In a Aholam, there's a beautiful temple of Lord Nisringadevi. Where is a Aholam located? Aholam is in the mountains. If you want to take darshan of Aholam Nisringa, you tighten up your pants because that is no joke to go up to that place. All kind of stuff up there. Right? You can have snakes, rats, birds, anything, alligators, bears, elephants, all kind of stuff running around up there. Right? So have your japa bag on tight. Anyway, so those are all mountains and everything. Where did he get the idea you should go to the forest? Certainly he didn't mean, because Hiranyakasipu was living in the heavenly planet, oh, it's only a short trip from here to go to Nanda Kanana, which is Indra's garden, where Menaka and them are. He wasn't talking about that, because he just got through criticizing Grasta life. So Vanam here means, our acharyas say, Vana means Vrindavan. You understand? Why? Because Krishna's his sister day. You should go to Vrindavan and take shelter of Sri Hari there. So what was Hiranyakasipu's response? He didn't become angry yet. He said, hey, son and Amarka, what are you all doing? I'm paying these heavy school tuitions every year, and you're not protecting my child? Right? They didn't have mass shootings. That wasn't an issue. But they had issues, maybe with sadhus leaking in, right? So he told him, you're not protecting my children, right? Some sadhu must have leaked in here and told him these things. Be careful. So he took Prahlad and said, hey, where'd you get all this stuff from? We never talked about this in class. I don't even have a course like that in our school. Tatsaruman, yeah. I don't have a course like that in school. Where'd you get all this stuff from, right? Prahlad Maharaj, he told him, look, Narada Muni told me about this. Friends and enemies, I heard about it philosophically. But now I'm actually seeing it directly. These people are crazy, right? So then later on, they continue to indoctrinate Prahlad, then they take him back to Hiranyakasipu. I'm speeding everything up. Hiranyakasipu. After Kayadu dresses Prahlad in very beautiful clothes, very sweetly smelling hair, he gives him to his father again. His father holds him. Just looking at Prahlad, he feels so much happiness. Tell me now, my son, what have you learned? Denzel voice. He tells him, huh? Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Parasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Rasya, Satyam, Atmanivedanam, Ittipumzapita, Vishnu, Bhaktasthinna, Valakchana, Vite Bhavati, Manye, Tamidam. Uttamam. Maybe it was last night. The ultimate goal of life. After you offer yourself in sacrifice. No, this is not the happening of somebody sneaking in. This boy has issues. I say, immediately tossed him off. And he said, what is this? Why are you speaking like this? I didn't teach you these things. No. Oh, Father, even if I told you myself, or even if others tried to teach you, you'd never be able to understand this. What do you mean I would never be able to understand this? Father, you're caught up in material life, and you're chewing that which has already been chewed. Your whole focus is on external life. Huh? Not te Vishnu, swatagati ni Vishnu, drashabhaya atamani na. Your values in life are all external. You can't understand this, but I think if somehow or another you got the grace of a real sadhu, not Shukracharya, indicating he didn't say it, right? If you got the grace of a real sadhu and you bathed in their foot dust, maybe possibly then he So Hiranyakasipu, only by his eyes, he guided his guards and henchmen to kill Prahlad Maharaj. So immediately they ran over and they started poking him. Kill him, stab him. This being, why do they have to yell out? I don't know. It's all big. Kill him, stab him. Yeah, that's what it says in Bhagavatam, so I have to go with it. Kill him, stab him, point him, stick him, all this different thing. Right? Prahlad Maharaj was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. So Hiranyakasipu goes, hey, obviously he cannot be killed like this, you stupid idiot. So then he told, listen, I'm a king. And if anybody should get that my reputation has come because I killed a 5-year-old boy who was my own son, this will not be good. Listen here. Go to the cooks and you tell them when we go to dinner tonight that they should put poison in Prahlad Maharaj's food. So that time they all went to dinner. Hiranyakasipu sat at the head of the table. Right, they brought all the food around. Prahlad Maharaj got the food. Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna Prayama. He started to offer his food, everything. Started honoring Prasad. Got to the inn. Did one belt. Got up. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. So this time, Hiranyakasipu, what in the world is going on here? Said, look here. Take him out for a walk. He likes chanting. Maybe he wants to go for a japa walk. Take him out for a walk. And when you get over there near where that cliff thing is, just toss him off, right? So he took Prahlad Maharaj and they went with him and they followed him and took him over to a cliff. At that time, as soon as he was chanting Hare Krishna, they grabbed him and they threw him over the cliff so they could hear Hare Krishna. So they heard something. Alright, so they went back to Hiranyakasipu and they took, we did what you asked us to do. So they were discussing it. How could this have been possible? This is my own flesh and blood, so forth, so on. And as they're discussing, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. So Hiranyakasipu, he began to lose it. So as he began to lose it, his own sister came. She said, brother, calm down. Right, have you taken your blood pressure medicine? Then she told, listen, you know I was given a boon that I can myself completely set myself on fire without being burned. Listen, I will take care of this for you. You just remember me. So Holika, she called to Prahlad, oh my dear Prahlad, come and sit on the lap of your auntie. So Prahlad Maharaj came, he sat in the lap, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. So Holika immediately, she embraced him very tightly, and immediately, just like a big lighter, she came on. So as everybody was staring very intently, the flames were getting really intense, just like those out of control fire yogis for new priests, right? They're putting too much ghee, put too much wood on, right? And everybody sitting around the fire going like this and everything, what have you. So the fire got out of control, everybody's like this, everybody's looking very strong, right? And all of a sudden you hear like, right? So all of a sudden they can hear holding, and in the meantime they also, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. After some time, all the fire subsided, all the smoke was just drizzling in the air, and there was those, like, you know, the crispy little, like, charred everything was there, and Holika was there also, just charred as could be, and Prahlad Maharaj, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. And Hiranyakasipu said, that's it. I don't know what to do. He became very dejected, very down. That time, Sandanamaka, I'm going to speed up, I'm really well. Sandanamaka ran in and they told him, listen, don't worry. My father's coming back tomorrow. Shukracharya. Do you know how powerful Shukracharya is? He was a disciple of Angiya Rishi, along with Brahaspati. They were like twin god brothers in the ashram of Angiya Rishi. But Angiya Rishi used to favor Brahaspati, so this made Shukracharya very angry. So Shukracharya went out one day, and he discovered a magic herb. Does anybody know what this herb is? Sanjeevani Ashwadi. The power of the medicine too, right? With that, he said, how you like me now, Gurudev? Right? But this mood not for serving Gurudev. So, then Angiya Rishi said, it's time to assign an acharya for the benefit of the demigods. So who did he become? Who did he make the acharya for the demigods? Brihaspati. Shukracharya became even more angry. So he left the association. He became the exact opposite. He became guru for the demons. At that time, when Shukracharya came back, right? Then Sundaramanga, they were very happy. They don't worry. So they went to greet their father. While they were greeting their father, long story short, they left Prahlad Maharaj in charge of the class. So if you can't beat him, what you do is you try to hype him up. Right? In other words, if you don't want to get down with our program, what we're going to do is we're going to give you a position. Right? You know how that works. I'm not going into the details. Right? So they gave him a position. Right? VGC or something like that? V. Vaikuntha. Right? The green body for the school. Okay. So they gave him a position. Right? And in that position, they told him, look, you take responsibility to watch over the children. So when they left Sundaramanga to go and greet their father, at that time, Palama said, hey, everybody put down your basketball. You put down the baseball. You put down your iPad. Listen, everybody come around. Let's all do Harinam. Harinam? What is Harinam? You know, why don't you engage in Harinam? He began to explain why, even from the very beginning of life, one should take up spiritual life. Then he began to give a whole series of instructions on Atma Tattva, Bhakti, Guru, Parasraya, everything he gave instructions. Swami, where'd you get this stuff from? Sundaramanga don't teach this here. It's not in the curriculum. We certainly didn't get it. Some kids began to say, we want to tell our parents because what's going on here? Your father's a king, therefore you're getting special classes. Right? All kind of things. Now, Prahlad told, oh, I got this from my Gurudev. What Gurudev? You don't have any Gurudev but Sundaramanga. No. Listen. He tells the whole backstory of his mother and how the demigods tried to kidnap her, but how then Narada Muni came and took her to his ashram. Narada Muni then imparted instructions on Atma Tattva, Guru Tattva, Bhakti, all kind of things to Prahlad. Prahlad absorbed all of this in the womb. Huh? From all of these things, now he was manifesting all the qualities of high-class Bhakti by the influence of Mahabhagavat Nard. Long story short, after that, Prahlad Maharaj then was taken back to his father. We can't do nothing with your son, right? Hiranyakasipu demanded, tell me where you're getting this power. Dad, I'm getting my power from the same place you're getting your power and everybody else. Who is that? Oh, Srihari. Srihari, where is he? Father's everywhere. Okay, is he in one of my pillars? Oh, listen here. What is that verse? Stavra deke na deke taramoti. Savatra Ishtadeva Smurti. Savatra Nija Ishtadeva Smurti. For pure devotee sees his Ishtadeva everywhere. So Prahlad looked in the pillar. That time he saw, Bhagavan is there, Father. Prahlad backed up a little bit. Yes, he's in the pillar. He is? That time Hiranyakasipu's anger reached its pinnacle. That means his own bhakti also reached its pinnacle. He took his sword in his hand and he struck the pillar. And as soon as he struck the pillar, that's what happened. So then, what happened was. Nrisimhadeva was furious. Hiranyakasipu then began to fight with Nrisimhadeva, and he battled up until the right time when it was not due, when it was not day, when it was not night, it was at dusk. He didn't kill him on the land or in the air, he put him on his lap. Nakor, Ankur, Upatita, Rit, Suroruham. He ripped him open and he took his heart and he raised it up like a lotus. Why did he do that? He killed Hiranyakasipu. Now he took out his heart, took his insides, garlanded himself, took his heart out, Ritsu Loruham means, held up his heart like a lotus flower. What was he showing? For anybody who has eyes to see, if you will know that this Hiranyakasipu is my very dear Jai, and Api Chet Sudur Acharo Bhajate Mam Ananya Ba, if you can see this, Shipram Bhavati Dharmatma, then very quickly your bhakti will go very high. If you don't understand it, just follow Dharma. He was a demon, I was a good guy, I killed a bad guy, you shouldn't do bad things. But if you can understand very deeply the path of bhakti, You should understand what kind of love and affection I have for my devotees. One devotee on our phone conference last night, this is the last thing, he asked, why was the scene so gruesome? So I told him, that scene was gruesome to you because you don't really fully understand bhakti yet. If you understand bhakti, the scene of Hiranyakasipu being ripped apart and Nrisimhadev galling himself, it is the most beautiful thing in the world. Because it shows the depth of the love between Bhagavan and his devotee. This is bhakti. For this reason, Gadadhar Pandit told this katha to Mahaprabhu at Yameswara Tota as a Srimad Bhagavatam katha. Mahaprabhu would take the impetus of that kind of love between Bhagavan and his devotees, get it stimulated at night in the Gambira, very deeply hidden, away from the public, and understand what is the love between Radha and Krishna. Jai Shri Nrisimhadev Bhagavan Ki Jai. Lord Premanande Hari.
I'm gonna go I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to Oh, Oh, my God. No, it's perfect.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, the ladies.
Vrindamari Purushantam Aham Bhajami.
You say the mantras when you put them to rest?
Yes.
I usually ring the bell when I do that.
Say again?
I usually ring the bell when I say the mantras to put them to rest. I'm not sure if you're supposed to, but that's what I do.
Yeah, I do it really.